Positive, being positive with life and never give up your love. I think that is the message. And I think everybody should watch it. Everybody will relate with the character in this film. It's a must watch. Thanks.
Lovely film, very, very emotional, very moving. Both the lead actors, Nasir and Kalki, have done such a fabulous job. So, my congratulations to the whole team.
Any message you'd like to give to
the audience? Yeah, they should watch the film. I mean, it's rare that you get movies that really move you so deep emotionally and are so relevant and so beautiful. I think go out and watch it.
Why didn't Divya come with you?
She's shooting in Tara, I think.
Okay.
Thank you.
So why should people observe?
It's a very emotional movie. It's very moving, very beautiful, and the two lead actors are marvelous, so they must go there. Thank you.
Question here from the gentleman in the front row.
Okay, I wanted to ask Banu and Aki that how much this would have changed if the subject, I mean, the language would have been Hindi predominantly. Because last time I saw a film which had a lot of English in it, like English is not really well. So it's pretty much relatable, as relatable a Hindi movie would have.
I think we were true to the characters. I mean, two people who live in a certain milieu. And, I mean, then that's India, right? I mean, there is Nasir's character who's a North Indian who's married to a South Indian. And there is Kalki who's from Mumbai and Delhi. And so when probably like, you know, if Nasir sir, they'll talk a bit of Hindi, but he's not going to speak shoot Hindi to South Indian wife. So I think the idea was to be true. I mean, and then there is Girish's character. So when he's going to talk to her, so everyone talks in their real accents. They talk in the English, they talk. So the idea is just to be very truthful to the characters and the milieu. So.
The spoken scenes would ring as true if it were to be spoken purely in any one language. For example, Kiran's are not explained, not talked about whether she's, you know, European or whether she's Indian or whatever. It's no importance. But she certainly looks like a person who would not be speaking Hindi. It would not be her language, really. So I personally like Khichdi or languages very much, because that's the kind of language we speak in real life.
I have one question. I'm Shailesh. I know one question is that scene which is, it says, when Kalki says to Nasir, I'm done with you, that's a kind of vision and the anger and the. Was it written exactly that, or was there some impression on that particular scene?
I think that's
the finest scene of the film. I mean, yeah. One of the finest scenes of the film when they two get into the shins and they said, we are done with each other. I mean, the way they. I thought some improvisation must have taken place.
It was all written.
It's all written.
Yeah. There may have been a line or two which we added, you know, my reaction to it says the size of a football, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But basically, it was, we played the scene as written. Though the way it was to be staged was slightly different in the original script, but then Anu and I sort of bashed our heads together. I bashed my head a little harder than she bashed my head. So,
yeah, as an actor, I was looking at that scene and I thought that this, you know, and we just missed the name of the writer then, who wrote also, like, you know.
Yes,
so give a big round of applause to her for that. I mean, that was so good.
I think the writer, Hosni
Yeah, just dialogue, screenplay, like just dialogue. जी साहब एक सवाल आपसे. I mean, इतने सालों उस जमाने से लेकर अब तक कभी अंडरप्ले नहीं करना, कभी लाउड नहीं होना, उस थिन लाइन को कैसे मेंटेन करना?
Yes.
I mean, yes. How do you do that? टेलीविजन का हम लोगों को मार डालता है. आई मीन वी हैव डन अराउंड 3-4000 एपिसोड्स. कभी अंडरप्ले नहीं करना, कभी लाउड नहीं होना. हाउ डू यू डू दैट? आई जस्ट वांट टू नो दैट.
यू यू द मूवीज वेयर आई हैव अ
नो आई हैव सीन व्हेन दे आई हैव सीन इवन ऑल दोस मूवीज. आई मीन
नो आई हैव योर लिस्ट दैट यू शुड सी. वन डे आई हैव अ फेस्टिवल हॉल. Dekhi, I thank you for what you're saying. Bahut shukriya, I appreciate it. Lekin ye underplaying aur overplaying jo hai, ye bade faulty qisam ke terms hain. And whenever I'm working with young actors, I make it a point to emphasize this, that there is no such thing as overacting or underacting. There is truth and falsehood. And otherwise, agar aap overacting, to phir then Kathakali is the worst kind of overacting. Or kabuki.
Yeah.
But that's not so, right? It is the kind of acting that is required for a particular form. So Hindi commercial cinema mein ek tarah ki acting zarurat hoti hai. Is tarah ki film mein ek dusre tarah ki acting ki zarurat hoti hai. I find myself much more comfortable in a subject like this, because main overacting bahut zyada achhi nahi karta hu. Kai log hai jo karte hain.
Jo log ye kehte hain ki picture thodi lambi ho gayi, इसमें ये हो सकता था, वो हो सकता था,
वो चलेगा.
मूवी खत्म होने के बाद मुझे लग रहा है कि और छोटी थी. इट्स अ ट्रीट टू वॉच दिस काइंड ऑफ एक्शन एंड द म्यूजिक.
इफ आई साइन अप तक ये डिसाइडेड उसके दिमाग में ऑलरेडी था कि हमको इस तरह की.
आई थिंक जी की कहानी है, इट्स अबाउट टू पीपल जो उनकी वर्ल्ड व्यू बहुत अलग है, और जब वो साथ में एक ही ट्रेजेडी को फेस करते हैं तो वो दे रियलाइज की दैट एक्चुअली देयर मच मोर इन कॉमन देन यू नो कल की जिसके मतलब 5000 फ्रेंड्स हैं ये हैं. पर जब वो यू नो लाइक बोलते हैं ना शिट हिट्स द सीलिंग, आई मीन शी इज सिटिंग इन कोचिन एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड हैज मूव्ड ऑन एंड देयर इज दिस मैन विद हुम शी हैज नथिंग इन कॉमन, और वो लोग वो किंड्रेड स्पिरिट्स यू नो काइंड ऑफ बन जाते हैं. तो इट्स अबाउट टू पीपल you know, so obviously I needed these two people who can represent these two worlds. So that's, I think it's just that, I think you are true to the character.
I also think that if Shiv had been a human, so it would have danger of getting a bit predictable, the relationship.
True, right.
If he was the same age as, what's her name? Thais, closer to age, then, you know, the temptation the writer may have had to fight against would be to know, the romance begin. But given the respective ages and how visibly so much older than Kalki, and yet you feel ke, hey, there's some sparks flying here, but what is it? So nothing which you fear might happen actually happens, you know. So I find that it's a very intriguing kind of a relationship to have two people of these two ages involved in a relationship like this.
So, you know,
my question to Anu and Kalki, hi, the younger here. I just wanted to ask, you know, like you have the whole rap about, you know, I have so many followers, so many friends, but nobody is here now. I kind of got the feeling that somewhere you also actively blocked them out. And if there was someone to reach you, you wouldn't have entertained that.
I think what happens is, obviously, when you're going through that situation, many people say, you hate them. You know, that's what he says. Because they hate everyone because they're not in the position that you are in. So, it's, you know, everybody is well-meaning, right? Everybody wants you to come back. But like, you hate every message. You think that, so that's it. So, obviously, and she realizes. When Ishita says in the last week, you know, you have to tell your mom. And first, she, and then she realizes actually her friend is right. But you don't want to kind of accept. So, in a way, what is it? They both are in the same stage, even though, you know, Shiv's character thinks he's reached the final zen stage. But film ke end mein both of them reach that zen stage, and that's the point of the film. So, yeah.
Anupur, since you said it came out of a very deep personal experience, would you also say the film in a way was cathartic for you?
I mean, yeah, I think in the initial phases,
happening in the initial, I mean, there is no such thing as catharsis, I feel. Pain doesn't ever go away. And but I think you kind of live with it and say that this is going to be a part of me. So I don't know, like, I've redefined catharsis in life. So.
You can take one last question.
Somebody have a toss between the two gentlemen.
I have a question.
Okay, go for it.
I just want to say that this movie is beyond this 200-300 crores.
Okay. That's it. It'd be nice if it gets...
I never mind it.
Do you mean beyond me? Beyond the 200-300 yeah, crores? Yeah. I'm so happy to hear that.
Quickly, sir. Yeah. Quick question.
This bending around of numbers, I find it vulgar. It's, you know, it's almost like confessing the real reason we make movies.
I think this could be the last question. Question to Kalki and Naseer ji. How much time did it take for both of you to lock in that ye film karni hai after reading the script?
Immediately. I read the script and then, usually if I read a script and I don't reply immediately, I'm not doing the film.
Got it. We'll probably keep that in mind.
Yeah.
Writing something.
Yeah, same with me. I read it through in one sitting. I immediately sent an email to Anu saying I'm definitely doing this movie.
That's an iconic email, I think.
We
read it very often.
Yeah, it's been circulated in certain groups, that email.
Fantastic. It is beautiful indeed. I've really enjoyed watching the movie. For everybody that's on screen and off the screen, big round of applause. They were super.
And how did you like the performance and the role you played of Tara?
I've seen the film before.
Okay.
I think it's a very beautiful film. It's truthful and relatable. And yeah.
Okay, tell me, how did you go about these searches? I mean, any preparation or something else?
A lot of preparation was actually sitting with my director Anu and rewriting some of the bits of Tara's dialogues. Making her more relatable, also more like a Bombay girl and stuff. So we did that together. And then, readings with Naseer sir just during the set. And it was quite a, we didn't do a lot of intellectual talking. It was just practice and work together.
After watching this film, what do you feel? Kuch kami rahi, kuch aap isse sochte hain ki wahan pe kuch aisa better ho sakta tha, acting ko leke, scenes ko leke.
क्या बेटर हो सकता है हमेशा ऐसे सोचती हूँ हर फिल्म के बाद दैट आई कैन डू बेटर आई कैन डू बेटर व्हिच इज व्हाई कीप एक्टिंग अगर मैं परफेक्ट थी तो मैं रुक जाती हूँ ना एक्टिंग आई फील ग्रेट आई फील रियली सुपर थैंक्स Yeah, I think there's a very beautiful relationship between Shiv and Tara, and it's a very unconventional, unusual relationship. You don't usually see a young woman and older man coming together on screen. And it's not your conventional romantic relationship, but there is love between the two, and they find a support and you know, comfort in each other.
We did
like a little bit of workshopping, probably for a few weeks, 2-3 weeks before the film, and then the film itself took about 30 days of shoot.
Any upcoming projects on your?
Yes, I'm doing a film with Konkana Sen Sharma, her first film as a director. It's called A Death in the Ganj, based in the 1970s on a true story. Thank you.
There's a difficult